Hello guys, welcome back to my SAP 2000 tutorial class. In this tutorial class, I am going to discuss what is global and local coordinate system in SAP 2000 software. And I will also discuss what is the default orientation of local coordinate system for node and line object. And finally, I will discuss how the result of the analysis depend on the local axis orientation of frame element. Please watch the full video and don't skip. I'm sure that after watching this video, you will have a clear concept about local and global axis. And please subscribe my channel for your support. So let's begin. Let's see what is global coordinate system. The global coordinate system is a three-dimensional right-handed rectangular coordinate system. It has three axes and they are denoted by x, y, z and they are mutually perpendicular and they also satisfy the right hand rule. Location in the global coordinate system can be specified using the variable x, y, z. If we draw any object in SAP 2000 software or if we define any coordinate system in SAP 2000 software, that will use global coordinate system as a reference. Let's see what is local coordinate system. In a structural model, there are many number of objects. Each object has its own coordinate system. This is called local coordinate system. Local coordinate system is used to define the section properties, loads, and also used to represent the response of an object. The axes of the local coordinate system are denoted 1, 2, and 3, and the color of this axis is red, green, and cyan or blue, respectively. Let's see what are the default orientation of local axis of nodes line object in SAP 2000 software. For node element, local axes are identical to global x, y and z axis respectively. Here you can see local 1, 2, 3 axes are parallel to global x, y and z axis respectively. Let's see the default local axis orientation for frame element. For frame element, the local axis 1 is always the longitudinal axis of the element, the positive direction being directed from end I to end j. If the frame element is not vertical, local axis 2 is always parallel to the global z axis. It means local axis 2 will be along the depth of the frame element and local axis 3 will be along the width of the frame element. If frame element is parallel to y axis, this will be the default orientation of local axis, and if the frame element is vertical, this will be the default orientation of local axis. That's mean local axis 1 will be parallel to the z axis and local axis 2 and 3 will be parallel to the global x and y axis respectively. If the frame element is not vertical, if it make angle less than 90 degree with x and y axis, this time this will be the default local axis orientation of frame element. Here you can see the local axis orientation for horizontal and vertical frame element. So for horizontal member, local axis 2 is always parallel to z axis. Local axis 1 and 3 is depend on the alignment of the frame element. If the frame element is parallel to x axis, this time it will be the default orientation, and if the frame element is parallel to y axis, this time it will be the default orientation. And here you can see also the local axis orientation for vertical member. If the vertical member in positive z direction, then this will be the local axis orientation. And if the vertical member in negative z direction, that time this will be the default local axis orientation of frame element. Let's see why is local axis required. I'm going to describe this with an example. Now imagine there is a beam which is parallel to x axis, and now we are applying a P load on it which is perpendicular to the longitudinal axis of this beam. So you can apply this load on beam by using the reference of global coordinates. Since this load is parallel to z axis, it means you can easily refer the z-axis to refer the direction of this force. But now if we rotate this beam with theta degree with xy plane, now if we want to apply this P load to perpendicular direction of this longitudinal axis, that time if you use global axis as a reference, you have to divide this load in two component, it's mean P cos theta and P sin theta, because these two component will be parallel to the global axis. So you have to use this component and value to represent the load with respect to global axis. But now if you define the local axis concept, you can easily refer this load along to local axis. So this is why local axis is very important in any structural analysis and design software. Local axis also used in analysis report. Here I have analyzed a 2D frame, and in this table you can see the element force. Frame element have total 6 number of unknowns, 3 forces and 3 moments. So here all forces and moments are represented with the reference of local axis. So here P is the axial force, it is in the direction of local axis 1, and V2 and V3 is shear force, it is in the direction of local axis 2 and 3 respectively. And here T is the torsion, the direction of this torsion along local axis 1, and here M2 and M3 is the moment, the direction of this moment along local axis 2 and 3 respectively. When M2 M3 moment will be there, how the beam will bend? Let's understand this. If the beam is parallel to the x-axis, so this will be the local axis orientation for this beam, and M3 mean the beam will bend like that, and M2 mean beam will bend like that, and torsion mean beam will bend like that. Let's see whether the output result depend on local axis orientation of frame member or not. Here I have analyzed a 2D frame. The direction of this frame element in upward direction and direction of this frame element in downward direction. So this is the default local axis orientation for these two column member. And here you can see M3 moment drag. So here blue color is denoted positive moment and red color is denoted negative moment. So here you can see the positive moment at this end. It's mean the moment direction in the direction of local axis 3. So that's why we are getting here positive moment. But for this column, here we are getting negative moment. And for this member, the local axis 3 direction in this direction. Since we are getting here negative moment, it's mean the moment at this node will be in positive y direction. So for both cases, we are getting moment value in same direction. So hence we can say that the output result of this structure doesn't depend on the local axis orientation. So that's all. I think now you have a clear concept about local axis of node and frame element. Still, if you have any doubt, you can ask me in comment box. And if you like this video, please tap on like button and also subscribe my channel.